Welcome to Just Wing It's Airwolf Battles. Today we are up against the US Navy. We will be fighting multiple waves of two FA-18 Super Hornets and a F-35 Lightning. I will be taking advantage of the ADF pod's 180 degree firing arc as well. I do have limited chaff and flares though, just to make things more interesting. I have multiple inbound Fox 3 missiles. First bandit down. I will have to do a lot of notching in this fight. Whenever we drop below 300 knots, rotors re-engage. This changes the flight dynamics of the aircraft, which can appear to be rather rough at times, as changing between vector thrust turbos and rotors is quite a big difference in turn rate and stability. This is why Airwolf was not an aircraft anyone could fly. Splash another bandit. Notching incoming missile. I think that one narrowly missed. Airwolf only has Fox 1 and Fox 2 missiles, no Fox 3 long-range missiles. The Super Hornets and the Lightning are only using Fox 3 missiles. Splash another bandit. I actually only have 4 Sidewinders, which of course are my Fox 2 missiles. The rest of the air-to-air missiles I use are Fox 1 Hellfire missiles, commonly found in attack helicopters. Into the merge for a dogfight. I have already fired using the ADF swivel ability. I am hoping the missile will track. Well, that's good timing. Just managed to see that missile hit. Another bandit splashed. I'm not sure that Hellfire will hit. It's a bit out of range. Dodging incoming missile. Wow, that was close. Firing another Fox 1. I have to get down to thicker air to notch missiles more easily. Air density slows down missiles faster. Well, my Hellfire splashed that one. It's the whole saying, you miss, I hit. Let's go vertical with these guys. The ADF pod certainly makes it much easier. I will try to use the mountain range, or shall I say hill range, to scramble the radar. Going up. Using full afterburner. I'm going to attempt what I call the slider maneuver. I do not think it is actually possible in real life. Using the vector thrust, high altitude lack of density, and Errol's high energy state to reverse climb. This will allow me to create an impossible attack angle and point my nose down at the enemy targets while still climbing. I've only been able to get it to work above 90,000 feet. Alright, it worked. Let's see how long we can maintain this attack angle. There we go, finally descending. splash another bandit. I love these guns. Let's take on one more. Splash last target. Let's head back home. I need to move that to the other monitor. Almost there, just over the hill. Let's vector in for final approach. gear down. And we're done. Thank you for watching. Please like, subscribe, share, and turn on notifications. Until next time.